हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मोहम्मद कामरन खलील फ्रॉम यूट्यूब चैनल द फिजिक्स गुरुज। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक रिलेटेड विद द कंप्लीशन ऑफ द वेक्टर्स बाय यूजिंग द पैरेललोग्राम। सो वेक्टर्स वर दोज क्वांटिटीज विच आर हैविंग अ पर्टिकुलर डायरेक्शन एज वेल एज मैग्नीट्यूड एंड अ यूनिट। सो इफ द वेक्टर्स आर एक्टिंग, फोर्सेज आर एक्टिंग, these are the vector quantities in the same direction, so the answer will be add up. But if the forces are anti-parallel, then what will happen? Larger force, the negative of a vector is minus 2, then it will give you 8 newton. And if the forces are perpendicular to each other, then what will be the answer? If it contains the MCQs by using the Pythagoras theorem, and when the system will be in equilibrium, then what will be the shape of the diagram? Arrow sign for a closed triangle, right, up and down. So in this way you will get the correct answer for the system in equilibrium. Now this is a challenge question for you, that from A, B, C and D, which diagram is correct for the forces which is having a resultant force? So which diagram is the correct one, whether A, B, C or D? Now guys, we will move towards the completion of the parallelogram. How can we add two vectors? So I will take a few examples from the past papers. So October November paper 2008, question number 1 from physics 5054. The main thing is the methodology. So whether I will take questions from A levels or O levels, the methodology matters. The syllabus doesn't matter right now because the procedure is same for both O levels as well as for the A level. So a microphone is held with two wires. The weight of the microphone is 6 newton, while the force of tension in the wire Y is 8 newton. So what is the force exerted on the wire X? So we are required to calculate this. One thing which you will observe, weight is a vector quantity. It always acts in downward direction. So it is a vertical force, always acts in downward direction. While this one, the force of tension in wire, Y is acting, you know, horizontal. So what is the angle between vertical and between horizontal? The answer is 90 degree, perpendicular to each other. The first step, this question contains 4 marks. The first step is write down a proper scale. So I have written that, let's suppose 1 cm equal to 1 newton, then 8 cm equal to 8 newton and 6 cm equal to 6 newton. So out of 4, you will get 1 for writing this. Now we will draw this diagram. So I will draw the line of 6 cm. As you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then I will make the angle of 90 degree and draw the line up to 8 cm. So I will label this. This is the force T and this is the force W, or the weight which is acting in downward direction. The arrow sign matters a lot. So you will label the arrow signs as soon as you will draw the diagram. Now I will open the compass, 6 cm. So I will open it from here. So I have opened the compass 6 cm. And then I will move towards the next side and I will mark it from here and 6 cm. So this is very important step, that when you will open the side, one side, then draw the arc from the other side, otherwise you will not get a parallelogram. So now what I will do, I will open the compass around, not around but exact 8 cm, and I will mark it from the other side, from the 6 cm side. So this is really very important step. Normally the questions of the students gets wrong when they will draw the wrong arcs from the wrong side. So what they have to do? So one side, if 6 cm, draw arc from the end of the other, and for the 8 cm, draw arc from the other side, that is end of the 6 cm. Join these two. So I will join this where they are interacting with each other, where they are crossed each other, this one, and then again this one. Now arrow sign, this and this one. Now where we will draw the resultant force. For the resultant force, for the vectors, we must know that tail, head, and then tail towards head. If in this diagram the force of tension and the weight, they are moving towards each other, it means that we will not draw the resultant force at this point, because it will not give you the correct answer. So if I will draw it over here, and now we will apply the rule, and then we will confirm. Now the two arrow signs will show the resultant force. Okay, this is the first vector, tail, head, tail, head, and this is tail and this is head. So two tail, two heads, and HT, like this one. So this one is the correct diagram. Now I will measure what is the value of the resultant force. So resultant force is 10 cm. So it means that it is equal to 10 N. But for this question, there is an error given in the answer as well. So the answer may range, the range which is given in the paper is 10.0 plus minus 0.2. So your answer may vary, 9.8 up to 10.2. So if your answer is not between this range, it means that you have to be more perfect in order to draw the parallelogram. Now the angle. Angle is always from one force to the resultant force. Now one force is the horizontal force, which is represented by the force of tension. So from force of tension, if you will measure this angle, it will become around 35 degree. So what I will write down, that 35 degree from T, or from horizontal, or 35 degree from y, and the resultant angle can be written in the other form as well, because this is the other force W. So now this angle will be 55. So I will write down the other answer, that 55 degree from W. And again, there is uncertainty given in the answer. So the answer may vary from 35 to 39 degree, 35 up to 39 degree, or 51 to 55 degree. I hope that now you have some understanding of how to draw the parallelogram. So draw it on your paper and do more practice. Now move towards the next question.